Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, now we are going to talk about the various properties that are being shown by the liquid phase or the liquid state. So let us know about it and let us know the new concept that would be emerging through this out whole property of a liquid. So now we are talking about the properties of liquid. Let us start with the first point. It says that in the liquid state, the molecules are closely packed or closely placed compared to that of the gaseous state, and hence have stronger intermolecular force of attraction. So now basically the thing is, we are now comparing, because initially we have talked about the gases that could be compressed or that could be liquefied. So now when the gases can be liquefied, and now we are going to talk about what is the characteristic or what are the properties of that of the liquid. So it, the first point indicates that the liquid molecules are basically very close to each other when then compared to that of the gaseous molecules. So what happens is, because of this liquid, when they are very much close to each other, this will generate the strong intermolecular force of attraction between the two molecules or two or more molecules, which is more than that of the gas, because the gas are basically very much apart from each other, and because of which they are not close. And yes, we cannot see that the gas could be compressed very easily in a normal temperature. So that is the thing. So the first point indicates that because of the strong force of attraction or intermolecular force, the liquid stays intact with each other, having these molecules that are very close to each other. So this was the first point that it was been talking about. So now second is, due to stronger intermolecular force of attraction, the mobility of a liquid is limited and hence have volume acquiring shape of the container. So now this is the main thing that we'll talk something which is very comparative to that of the gaseous state, because the second point it says that the intermolecular force of attraction is very more than that of the gas, that was also been repeated in the first point. But in this case, they are talking about the mobility. Mobility means, for example, if you would see, the gases are basically widely spread. So because there is no force of attraction between them, and yes, the intermolecular distance is also more. But they are mobile, they can move. But talking about the liquid, even the liquid can move. But yes, they will acquire the shape of the container also, but the mobility is also very less, because they are placed in a specific containers, or they are being placed in a situation where they cannot be mobile or they cannot be moved like that of the gas, because the gas has more mobility compared to that of the liquid, and compared to that of the solid, because the solid has no mobility in that case. So what happens is, because of the liquid, it acquires only, it has a volume, but it will acquire the shape in which it has been kept. For example, suppose if it has been kept in a cup, so it will take the shape of the cup, but not, because it is not being mobile like that of gas, so it won't acquire the overall shape of that cup. It will acquire the shape up to a limited range, that is below the surface of that. But gas, it cannot be, that is, we cannot place a gas in a cup. We have to contain that gas in a close packed thing. So the liquid has the two differences. That's the reason, and because of intermolecular force of attraction, there are the different properties than that of the gases. So this is the second point that we have talked about. Now talking about the third point. Yes, they have relatively high density than that of gas. Obviously, it is a very common thing that to understand. Density is somewhere, we know that mass upon volume. So somewhere, if we are talking about the gases, actually the gases will somewhere it occupies more space, but the molecules in a particular ray or in a particular unit volume is less than that of the liquid, because in a particular unit volume there are more number of moles of the liquid gas that we could easily calculate, and this makes that the liquid is more dense than that of the gaseous state, in spite of having no less mobility. Then we could say that because of the intermolecular force of attraction, they will have more density than that of the liquid. So now moving towards the next point, that is all the liquid possess characteristic boiling points and freezing point. Yes, this is the thing that we have to talk about, that the boiling point and freezing point of a particular liquid is being the character of that liquid. For example, if we know that water, if we say water, then water has a specific boiling point, that is 100 degrees Celsius, and that of freezing point is again that we know it has 0 degrees Celsius. So whenever we say that a liquid which has 0 degree Celsius as a freezing point, then the first liquid that clicks in our mind is basically water. And anything we know that that 100 degree Celsius is for a boiling point of a particular liquid, then again we think that we are talking about basically water, because this liquid has a specific characteristic. So because of the boiling point and because of the freezing point, we could characterize whether what would be that liquid. So this is the characteristic of the liquid that we have talking about in point number 4. And now let's move towards the point number 5th, which says that the liquid has a strong intermolecular force and have high boiling point, and that are known as basically non-volatile liquids. Yes, when you are talking about liquids, then liquids are basically of two types, that is non-volatile and volatile. So basically when we are talking about volatile liquids, so basically volatile liquids are those liquids which will have strong intermolecular force of attraction, which will let us to give more amount of energy so as to boil or so as to make that liquid to in an equilibrium with one atmosphere pressure. So therefore more energy is being required, and hence the boiling point of that kind of liquid whose intermolecular force of attraction is more are basically known as non-volatile liquids. So talking about a non-volatile liquid, basically I would say consider a small example, a simple example like water. So water in a normal state, basically it has 100 degrees Celsius of temperature when we are talking about the boiling point. And more about that many organic compounds are having more than 100 degrees Celsius of temperature, so that makes them a non-volatile compound. So means we have to provide more energy, or we have to provide more heat or more temperature so that the liquid could be boiled. So basically that liquids are known as non-volatile liquids. And moving towards the next one, the liquids having low boiling points are due to the weak intermolecular force of attraction and are basically known as volatile liquids. Volatile liquids like ether, alcohol. Alcohol have the boiling point less than 60 degrees Celsius. It depends on which alcohol we are talking about, but generally an alcohol has less than 100 degrees Celsius or less than 80 degrees Celsius of temperature. So what makes them to be having less boiling point is because they have no intermolecular force of attraction or less weak intermolecular force of attraction, which makes them to boil very easily at lower temperature also. So that kind of liquids are basically known as volatile liquids. And yes, we have to be careful with the volatile liquids, because as we could see that in trucks also, some liquids that we transport from one region to another region, they have a mentioning on the truck that they are basically volatile liquids. So basically they are very dangerous to hold, and because more easily they could catch fire. So that is basically volatile liquids. So now moving towards the next one, that is the 7th point, which says that the flow of liquid is affected due to friction between adjacent liquid layers known as viscosity. Something we are now going to talk about, viscosity. Viscosity is basically the friction between the two layers of the liquid when they pass through each other or when they are over each other. So the liquid flows actually. When the liquid is allowed to flow, what happens is the two layers of the liquid, they will allow the friction between each other. So what happens is the speed or the velocity or the flow of the liquid will get resisted or will get slowed down. This kind of property is basically known as viscosity of the particular liquid due to friction between the two layers of the liquid. So now talking about the last one. Yes. On the surface of a liquid, the molecule experiences unbalanced force and gives rise to the phenomenon known as surface tension. Again, this is the thing, or this is the property that are being exhibited. That is, when we are talking about viscosity and surface tension, these are the two properties that are being shown by the liquid only. And in which the surface tension says that it is the kind of force that holds the liquid to downwards when it comes to basically the surface, as you know, because when you're talking about the gas has been occupying all the spaces when it has been kept in a container. But while talking about the liquid, it will only occupy that space below the surface. So that kind of stress that holds the liquid to stay down is basically known as the surface tension. So we are going to learn about the viscosity and surface tension in more detail in the future lectures. So basically this is the few properties of the liquids that we have learned now. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood that what are the various properties of the liquid. So share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe Ikeda channel. Thank you so much.